Hello, my dear children and parents. Welcome to class 8 of Indus Valley Public School, RAT. So, my dear children, today we are going to study about a mystery. Mystery of whom? Yours? No. It's about a cat. It is a mystery of the cat, and the name given to this mysterious cat is McCavity. This poem is composed by T.S. Eliot. McCavity, the mystery cat. It is an immortal creation by him, by T.S. Eliot. And he composed this poem in a satirical or humorous rhythm. He describes him as the mystery cat, the hidden paw, and Napoleon of crime. T.S. Eliot created the poem after he got inspired by the character of Professor James Moriarty of Sherlock Holmes. Okay, so he composed this poem after getting inspired. Now, children, before we start with the poem, I would like to tell you about the poet. So he is Thomas Steens T.S. Eliot, and he was born in St. Louis, Missouri, USA, but eventually settled in England. He was born in St. Louis, Missouri on 26th September 1888. He lived in St. Louis during the first 18 years of his life and attended Harvard University, a classist in literature, an Anglo-Catholic in religion, and a realistic in politics. He rose to become one of the greatest poets of the 20th century. He was awarded a Nobel Prize for Literature in 1948. His best known poems are The Wasteland, Ash Wednesday, and Four Quartlets. He died in London on January 4th, 1965. Children, this is about your poet who composed the poem Mystery, the McCavity Cat. So now here is your poem, McCavity. See how horrible, no? So I'll read out the poem, and children, you will see here some alphabets are written in the bracket. These alphabets are representing the rhyme scheme of the poem, so go through accordingly. Okay, now you must be clear what are the rhyme schemes. So I read out the poem first, and then I'll give you the explanation of it. So here comes your poem, McCavity, the mystery cat. McCavity is a McCavity cat. He calls the hidden paw, for he's the master criminal who can defy the law. Here defy means to disobey the rule. He is the bafflement of Scotland Yard, the flying squads disappear. For when they reach the scene of crime, McCavity is not there. McCavity, McCavity, there's no one like McCavity. He's broken every human law, he breaks the law of gravity. His power of levitation would make a fakir stare. And when you reach the scene of crime, McCavity is not there. You may seek him in a basement, you may look up in the air. But I tell you once and once again, McCavity is not there. McCavity is a ginger cat. He's very tall and thin. You would know him if you saw him, for his eyes are sunken in. His brow is deeply lined with thought, his head is highly domed. His coat is dusty from neglect, his whiskers are uncombed. He sways his head from side to side with movements like a snake. And when you think he's half asleep, he always wide awake. McCavity, McCavity, there's no one like McCavity. For he is a fiend in feline shape, a monster of depravity. You may meet him in a by street, you may see him in the square, but When a crime is discovered, then McCavity is not there. So this is the poem, and in the bracket I have mentioned the rhyme scheme. So now I'll give you the explanation of the poem. So coming to the first four lines of the poem, first stanza. So your first stanza, McCavity is a mystery cat. He called the hidden paw, for he is the master criminal who can defy the law. He is the base filament of Scotland Yard. The flying squads disappear, for when they reach the scene of crime, McCavity is not there. So in this given line, poet is saying that McCavity is a mysterious because he is obscure to all of us. Obscure means unclear. Nobody can find out what she is doing, what he is doing. He is very doubtful case. He described as a hidden paw because he does all the works of crime in complete secrecy. To justify that he is a criminal, he defies law. Even the Scotland Yard and the Flying Squad are unable to catch him. And thus McCavity is a reason of failure and hopeless for the police agency. Whenever there is a crime discovered, McCavity is not to be found there. So this is what explained in these four lines. The written explanation is here, just see to it. The poet describes a mysterious cat in this poem. It stands for hidden paw, a symbol of crime and cruelties, that is Napoleon. Here in the poem, the cat is a mysterious figure. Even the famous detective agencies like Scotland Yard and the Flying Squad, that means group of police officers in England, are not able to find it out. He is the master criminal who defies any law. He is the cause of the bafflement of the detective agencies like Scotland Yard and Flying Squad. He is too clever to be caught by anyone. When they reach this place of crime, the mysterious cat is not there. So nobody is able to find this mysterious cat. Okay? And bafflement means puzzlement, means confused. Okay, my dear children? Now coming to the another lines of the poem, second stanza. McCavity, McCavity, there's no one like McCavity. He's broken every human law. He breaks the law of gravity. His powers of levitation would make some fakirs stare. And when you reach the scene of crime, McCavity is not there. You may seek him in the basement. You may look up in the air. But I tell you once and once again, McCavity is not there. So in the given lines, McCavity is an apparel. He is unique. He is a master in breaking laws made by human. He even breaks the law of gravity. Which law of gravity? Gravity you have already studied in science, means anything that is attracted towards the land. Fine? We are walking, why? Because there is gravitational force. So, but this cat, he broke the law of gravity with his agile and astounding jump. So, agile means very much, you can say, alert, swift jump. Jo hawa mein udte rehte hain, aapne dekhe honge na horror movies mein. So, this cat is in a similar fashion. Never used to be on land, every time flying. Okay? When he jumps, he floats in the air, which makes even a fakir, means unknown supernatural abilities, looked in a startled way. Searching McCavity will give futile result, means not a good result, not a fruitful result. You may search him in the basement or in the air, but you are not going to find him anywhere. This is what given in these lines. I'll give you the written explanation. So now no one is like McCavity. He has broken every human law. Why human law is said here? Means humanity, like love, care, understanding. Nothing is there in the cat. He used to trouble the people. He used to, he is not kind to any people, do all kind of mischief, do harms to the people. So human law is broken by him. And then he even breaks the law of gravity, because he never used to be on the ground. He used to fly in between in the air. He has the power to rise or float in the air. I make even a magician stare at his flying in the air. So what happened is, poet is saying that even the magicians would be astonished to see him flying in the air. You may search for him in the basement, or you look for it in the sky. But after doing crime, it is not found anywhere. It is hidden. It is gone from that particular place. So this is the explanation of this stanza. Now coming to the next stanza. Now in the stanza, it is a description of the cat is given. Let's see what kind of description is there. McCavity's a ginger cat. He's very tall and thin. You would know him if you saw him, for his eyes are sunken in. His brow is deeply lined with thought. His head is highly domed. His coat is dusty from neglect. His whiskers are uncombed. He sways his head from side to side with movements like a snake. And when you think he's half asleep, he's always wide awake. See how confusion creating this cat is. You people are thinking he's sleeping, but no, he's not sleeping. He is always awake. He is always awake. Fine. So come with the explanation. I'll just explain this line. So in this lines, cat description is given, how it look, how it maintain himself, how he used to be in his life. So McCavity, what the structure of the McCavity, it is like a ginger who is lined with tall, with eyes sunken. So he's having a deep eyes. And you can recognize him when you see him with brow line, with deep thought. And every time he is in a deep thought, he is having a mark on his forehead. Okay? He is very clever about his dress. So he is never caring. He never used to care about his dress. So what? Why? Because his coat is dusty with neglect. His overcoat is full of dust, because he did not care about his dress. He does not even comb his whiskers, never used to comb. And when he moves with caution, he moves his head like a snake from left to right and vice versa. So his movement is like a snake. If you think that McCavity is half asleep, you are making a mistake. He is always wide awake. This is there in this lines. So now coming to the written explanation of this paragraph. So, poet is saying that when you think he's half asleep, he's always wide awake. And he proceeds to describe the cat by telling us that he is brown in color, very tall, thin in body. How we make it a brown in color? Because ginger shape, ginger cat, it is tall. So, what is the color of the ginger? Brown. So, it is mentioned that it is brown in color. His eyes are sunken and eyebrows are deeply lined with thought. So whenever we are in a thought, we will be sikod lete na apne eyebrow ko and V mark type ka ban jata. That is only explained over here. So now his head is round in shape. His coat is dusty. That means its fur are dusty. And his whiskers, long stiff hair grown near the mouth. जो यहाँ पे उसके मूछे type की जो निकलती है ना cats में, that is only whiskers. And tangled, not combed. So these whiskers are tangled, they are not combed. While moving like a snake, he sways his head from side to side as if in search of some prey. He is so alert that in sleep also it is found awake. Okay? So it is said that even in his sleep, he is always alert. People used to think that he is sleeping, but he is very alert while sleeping also. Okay, children? Now coming to the fourth stanza, McCavity, McCavity, there's no one like McCavity. For his finned in feline shape, a monster of depravity, you may meet him in a by street, you may see him in the square. But when a crime's discovered, the McCavity is not there. Again, he went from that particular place. So it is told in this line ki, according to the poet, McCavity is a devil in the shape of a cat. He does not have any value of morality. He is a master in moral corruption. You may meet him by chance at the by street or in the square, but you must be sure that when there is a crime, McCavity will not be found there. As soon as the crime is conducted, McCavity cat gone from that particular place, and nobody is able to find out where the cat is. Okay, so now coming with the written explanation. In this stanza, the poet says that there is no one like McCavity in his devilness. He is finned, that is cruel and unpleasant, in the guise of a cat. He is a monster of wickedness. He may be seen in a by street or in a square, that is plaza or open place. But when people come to know about a crime, there is always found. So whenever crime is conducted, yeah, crime will be there, but cat will not be found in that particular place. Okay, fine. Now we will be seeing the literary devices or the poetic devices used in the poem. So I already written the rhyme scheme A A B B A A B B C C, something like that. So we already written in front of the poem. See here. So these are your rhyme schemes. C C C. I'll show you. I've already mentioned, no, the C C T here. I mentioned, no, A A B B in the bracket. So these are all the rhyme schemes. Please go through it. Okay. Now coming to the poem. Rhyme schemes. Okay. Literary devices. So first I wrote about the rhyme scheme. The rhyme scheme of the poem McCavity. The McCavity cat is AABB. Eliot uses many literary techniques to make the poem appear humorous to the readers. Instead of using a human as the main character, he uses a cat and attributes human quality to it. The list of literary devices used in the poem is analyzed below. The first is rhyme scheme we have already discussed in the poem. Then simile. What is a simile? Simile is a figure of speech in which two dissimilar objects are compared and the comparison is made clear by the use of the term like, such as, and so on. He sways his head from side to side with movements like a snake is a fine example of simile in the poem. Now it is a personification. I already told cat is personifying the human. Okay, so personification is there. What is there in the personification? Attribute human qualities to some inanimate object is known as personification. They says he cheats at card is an example of personification. Like a human, the poet suggests that McCavity plays card and cheats at him. The readers know that a cat cannot play card, but it can break any human law and get away with it. The use of anthropomorphism makes the poem seems unrealistic but humorous. Now repetition lines are there. McCavity is not there. He has been repeated this line number of times in the poem to emphasize on the fact that cat is too clever to be caught. Next, McCavity, McCavity, there's no one like McCavity is another line which is repeated in the poem to highlight the fact that there is only one criminal mastermind, and that is McCavity alone. Some alliterations are also used in the poem. Like repetition. What do you mean by alliteration? Alliteration means that repetition of the consonant sound in a close connection, or you can say that repetition of same alphabet nearby. For example, his head is highly, then repetition of the first word H. Tall and thin, repetition of T. He is half asleep, repetition of H. He is faint in feline, may meet, repetition of FF and MM. That's all there in the poem from my side for the description. Children, go through the poem, go through the description, write about the poem, poet, and explanation. If you feel like to write, you can write the explanation of the poem, but you must be clear about the literary devices that is used in the poem. Make sure learn the things, because in the next doubt session I'm going to ask you with the questions. So my dear children, here I take a leave. Thank you so much. Enjoy yourself. Bye-bye.